From the sound a door makes when it closes to the beautiful sound of a symphony orchestra, you've likely heard something recorded by award-winning company, Audio for the Arts. It's a full-service recording studio that serves the music industry, the business industry, and so much more. We're talking this morning with Noah Gilfillan about summer recording in Madison, and I am very glad to see you.
Yeah, good to see you again.
So, you are so busy. I love what you guys are doing. The Madison Area Music Awards just happened, and I would be shocked if you didn't win something.
We did win something this year. We're very fortunate to everybody who voted, so thank you if anybody's watching this and voted. Thank you. We got a Best Recording Studio, and Buzz got an award for Front of House Sound Engineering because he does a lot of live sound for Madison Symphony Orchestra. So he got a little award for that, yeah.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
So well deserved. Yeah. And of course, we'll give a shout out because Buzz and Audrey are often the ones sitting here on the couch.
Right. Yep.
So, hi, guys. We miss you. But we have Noah, and we're glad to have you. Let's talk a little bit more about the awards, though. So, you guys have won some awards. What about your clients? Because you work with so many great folks.
Yeah, and they got a lot of recognition that they all well deserve. Work, spelled W-U-R-K, they're a really awesome funk band here in Madison. They kind of swept it. They got Artist of the Year, Jazz Performer of the Year, Pop Song of the Year, Album of the Year that I recorded with them. They got Best Album of the Year. Some other standouts were Leslie DeMasso, who is a really amazing kind of like operatic jazz type singer. She got Best World Music Album. Mike Zirkel, who has done a lot of work with us, he got a Hall of Fame Sound Engineering Award, so kind of like a very high level award for him, which is well deserved. He does a lot of mixing for projects we record, so
wow.
Yeah, a lot of well deserved recognition given out this year.
So there are some impressive people coming in and out of the studio regularly, but now we can even say award winning.
Yeah, award winning. That's
award
right.
Award winning in there in your award winning studio. Now, you are always up to something unique. What are some of the cool projects you're doing lately?
Well, just this past weekend, actually, we did tracking for Work's new album, so that was super fun. Buzz is out in Banff in Canada right now doing voiceover stuff for American Family Insurance. They have these big kind of year-end conferences, or year-end being the middle of their year, you know. End of the second quarter, so he's out there doing that, and Audrey is doing sound for a really fun indie film called Survival Guide right now, so there's been lots of Foley and sound effects and dialogue recording going on. So,
you know, I did see some video of her standing outside recording some sirens.
Yeah, when the power went out,
right.
We're sitting at the studio like, what do we do at a recording studio with no electricity? I'm like, oh, well, we might as well record all this chaos.
Get the chaos on record. I think that's a great use of time.
Yeah.
Let's talk more about the concert series Acoustic Moose. We've talked about this on the show recently, and you've partnered with WVMO for that series. So what does that mean exactly?
So we'll be broadcasting past shows on 98.7 WVMO. They're out in Monona, really awesome like volunteer radio station. Mm-hmm. And they actually won some broadcasting awards recently too. I don't know the name of the awards, but
such a talented community.
We just like to work with good people, and so they'll be broadcasting old shows, and then we're kind of working on having a few special live stream concerts where we stream the video and whatnot to their website. So
how neat. Yeah. And when is the next Acoustic Moose?
The next broadcast Acoustic Moose is going to be on August 16th, and that will be One Human Band. That's Brian Druyer. He's a really awesome local musician. And then the next Acoustic Moose in our studio will be the next day, August 17th, with jazz vocalist Susan Hofer.
So much fun.
Yeah.
Now, we've talked a lot about musical recordings in this interview today, but you do other things for Audio for the Arts as well. What other kinds of work do you do?
We do a lot of podcast recording these days, actually. We just finished up a series called Talkbacks to Go for American Players Theater, so we've been doing some podcast recording with them. Actually, after this, I'm going to go record a podcast for the Radiological Society of North America, talking about oncology and all that good stuff, so kind of touching on lots of different areas. But
I bet you learn a lot doing
this. I do. I feel very fortunate to just sit in a chair and hit a big red button and listen to smart people talk about stuff.
Sounds like a fabulous job.
Yeah, it's all right.
So I will tell you, I follow you guys on Facebook because you have so many great postings. You get some kind of sneak peeks into what's going on behind the scenes at the studio, and I love that. Is that a great way for viewers to find out more about what you're doing?
Yeah, if you go to our website, that's just audioforthearts.com, there's links to our Facebook and our Instagram, which are the ones we kind of keep the most up to date. And then if you email afa@audioforthearts.com with newsletter in the subject line, we've been doing a monthly newsletter where we just kind of let everybody know what's going on and upcoming Acoustic Moose shows and all that kind of stuff. So that's another great way to get connected.
Wow, you get to see a little bit about the day in the life of Audio for the Arts.
That's
well,
right.
Noah, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, my pleasure.
Nice to see you. I want to thank all of our guests for joining us today. And of course, we thank you so much for watching. I'm Jessa Jeremiah. I'm going to see you next time on Talk Wisconsin.